Hey guys, how's it going? It's Atsu. So today I'm going to answer some of the questions that I got on Instagram. Let's get into it. What was the most nervous moment in your life? When I first started at Deloitte, I was like super, super nervous. It wasn't just because it was my first job, but Deloitte is like one of the big four accounting firms, so there are so many smart and talented people working there. Of course, the whole place operates in English, so it was a little bit intimidating for me. But deep down, I kind of felt that if I had to choose, taking the harder road would give me more chances to grow and also lead me to a better life. So I just went through it, and now, no regrets at all. What is your motivation for studying? I just really love that feeling of getting better at something. And also what's interesting is, before I started diving into English, I never really got that feeling. So English was like the first thing that showed me how awesome it is to grow. And even now, I totally see that there is a lot of room for improvement in my English, like especially around pronunciation and vocabulary. And working on them is a lot of fun for me. What type of cosmetics do you use daily? Because you get that clean look. Thanks for saying that, but there's nothing super fancy I use. I use moisturizer. Actually, this is my go-to. And well, I'm not super picky about browns or anything, but this is one of the things that my friend recommended to me. And I quite like it. And also I apply sunscreen because I've heard like a million times that UV rays are the biggest skin enemies. So this is one of the things I use on a daily basis as well. Have you ever hit an English learning slump? I mean, there were times when I felt like I wasn't making huge progress like I used to. But like if you think of the learning curve, right? Like at first you are making a lot of progress, but eventually you reach this plateau. So calling this a slump kind of like sounds a little bit downerish, I think. So I just think of it as part of the whole learning journey. What is your favorite movie? I don't really watch a lot of movies, so it's a little bit tough. But if I had to say, maybe Spirited Away is definitely up there. I just can't get enough of it. What's your favorite and least favorite food? This might sound super cliche for a Japanese person, but I like yakiniku, sushi, and curry. Those are my fave. On the flip side, I'd say no to green peas. Like, I'd get super annoyed if someone snuck them into my food. I just don't see any value in them. Did you face any challenges living abroad, apart from the language? Well, to be honest, not really. And I think it's because I'm, you know, that kind of person who doesn't really label things as like problems or failures. If you're kind of numb to setbacks, you just keep pushing forward, right? And I think that's led me to quite a lot of wins for me. Take this YouTube channel, for instance, right? Like somebody might have thought that this was a complete bust, but I just kept going at it and look where we are now. Favorite YouTube channel? So if I had to pick my top YouTube channels, there would be Matt Devella, MKBHD, and Ali Abdaal. The quality of their content is just out of this world. What's your favorite distinction phrase or words? It's a tough call, but I've got to say, put your money where your mouth is. It's my favorite. It's catchy, and honestly, it's just so true. Like, there aren't many people who really walk the talk, and so I'm just trying to live by it. Who do you look up to? Well, I get this question a lot, but I don't really have any like specific people that I look up to. That doesn't mean that I don't get impressed by people. Like, I get impressed like every day. So for instance, my video editor is a genius. My designer is incredibly talented. And Nick, for example, is super, super entertaining. And he's a great performer, right? So working with them always blows my mind. But I think, you know, there is a big difference between like being super impressed by someone and actually looking up to them. So yeah, I don't really have anyone specifically I look up to. Do you even exist? I hope so. What do you think? What are you into? It's so typical of me, but I'm really into my work. So recently we've been working on new videos, and we also have some products in the pipeline, which is exciting. So we've got a lot of things on my plate, and there is a limit to the extent to which how much we can share about those products right now. But yeah, my work is definitely the most exciting thing in my life. What is your motto? Always be in control of your life is my motto. Like, if you look around, like you notice so many people who seem to be in the back seat of their lives. Like, they're just doing things they don't love and thinking maybe like, you know, that's just life, right? It is what it is. But that's not the kind of life I envision for myself. To break free from that cycle, you have to consciously make an effort to drive your own life. So always be in control of your life. That's what I live by. Please tell me your recommended places in Australia. I recommend Patricia for coffee. It's got beautiful, cozy ambience and the coffee is great, needless to say. And like, it totally changed my perception to coffee. I also recommend Cumulus Inc. for more Aussie food. Again, it's got good atmosphere and also it's got nice food, not too expensive, and a wide selection of wine as well. So it's a great place. I highly recommend it. Right, that's it. Thank you so much for your questions. If you'd like a transcript of this video, you can download it from my official LINE account. Bye!